Hello and welcome back to Excelsive. Today we are checking out a lesser known gem in Microsoft 365 Excel, the take function. This function allows you to precisely extract data from a range or array, and it's a powerful tool for managing your data. Stick around as we explore how to use the take function, syntax, and practical examples. Let's get started. Just to give you an example of what's to come, we are going to understand the take function, how to use it, then we are going to combine it with functions like SORTBY, filter, and VSTACK. All this will be done with practical examples so you could understand the formula and its hidden value. Before we get into these examples, let's understand what the take function is and why it's valuable. The take function is a feature available in Microsoft 365 Excel that allows you to extract a specific number of rows and columns from a range or array, giving you precise control over your data. Now let's quickly check its syntax. Here, array represents the range or array from which you want to extract data. This could be a range of cells in your Microsoft 365 Excel worksheet. Rows is an optional argument that allows you to specify how many rows you want to extract. If omitted, it will extract all the rows. Columns is also an optional argument that lets you specify the number of columns you want to extract. Again, if omitted, it will extract all columns. I guess that's enough of the theory part. Now let's jump to some examples, because that's where we are going to learn how to use it and why is it important. We'll start with the simplest example. Here we have a data set of our clients and the revenue we generated from them for the last two quarters, April 2023 to September 2023, in a nice little table. If we are to use the take function in its simplest form, it will be like this: take, then select your table. That's the only mandatory argument of this function. Put a comma and close brackets, press enter. What does it do? It brings the whole table. I can hear the dismissive arguments already. Why do we need this? It's useless. I could have used VSTACK. Why do I have to learn this? But stick around and I'll tell you why it's important. And up at this point, all these arguments are valid. By now, the take function looks completely useless and VSTACK can do the same thing. Let me show you here. VSTACK, then select our table and press enter. Same result like a bare bones take function. But neither this is the best use of VSTACK nor it's for the take function. By the way, check out our video on VSTACK to get ahead of your colleagues. You'll find the link on the top right and in the description. Getting back to our take function, let's edit our formula to include some selective rows and columns. Let's say we just want top 5 rows and first 3 columns. So we edit our formula too. We already have the array selected, so we just mention 5 for rows and 3 for columns. And here we have our values. I must clarify, when I said top 5 rows, it doesn't mean top 5 in value, like the top 5 in highest revenue, but simply the first 5 rows or columns. Similarly, if we want the last 5 rows and the last 3 columns, we can use the rows and columns argument with a negative sign, like this. Now we have the rows and columns starting from the end. So that's how it's different from VSTACK, which pulls the whole table, and take has the ability to pull selective rows and or columns. Now some of you who have been using Excel for long and are aware of choose calls and choose rows might argue that take is similar to them. Because if I am to pull first 3 columns using choose calls, I will write my formula as choose calls, then select my table, 1, 2, 3. And this will bring column numbers 1, 2, 3. Your argument won't be completely wrong, but with two major exceptions. First, choose calls and choose rows are two separate functions, while take kind of merges both of them into one. Second, choose calls and choose rows both need you to list all the rows or columns respectively. So if you have a table with 100 rows and 100 columns, and you need to get the first 50 rows and first 50 columns, you can imagine how your choose calls and choose rows formula look like. But with take, it's quite simple. Now that we've got the basic use of the take function out of the way, let's move on to some more interesting examples. Let's say in our same data, we need to find the average and total of the first 5 clients and the last 5 clients. I already have the headers prepared for us, so we begin our formula as average. Then for the number argument, we will use the take function. So take, then select our table. We need the first 5. So rows will be 5. And for columns, we need a result from these 6 rows. But if we just write 6, it will start from the first column here, which is the client's name, and end here at August 2023. We don't want that. So to fix this, we will use minus 6, which will make our take function to start from the end. Put double closing brackets, one for the take function and one for the average function. And here we have the average of our first 5 clients for all the months from April 2023 to September 2023. Let's verify our result. Let's select this data. And now let's check our average value down here. It's the same. So a job well done. Now let's check the average of the last 5 companies. We can bring the formula down. So let's press Ctrl D and edit this formula by pressing F2. And we just have to change the rows argument to minus 5 since we wish to get the average from the bottom. Press enter and done. Again, let's verify our results. So select these columns in question and it matches perfectly. Now let's move quickly to the next task at hand, totaling the first 5 and the last 5. We start by sum. Then for the number arguments, we start our take formula and select our table. Again, for rows, we choose 5 and for columns, we choose minus 6. Double closing brackets and done. Same thing for the last 5. Ctrl D to bring the formula down and just change the row argument from 5 to minus 5 and done. But isn't this taking the long way? We could have done this with simple average and sum formulas, right? Let's check this. Let's write our average formula for the first 5 right next to this one here. Average, then for our numbers, we carefully select our first 5 rows and then go for the columns. And here is our result, same as before. Now let's try the average for last 5. This time, Ctrl D won't be much useful, so we start by average and then select our rows and columns, like this. And we have our average. Let me do the sum formula as well, and then we shall move ahead. Here. Now we have our average and totals, so why would we want to use take at all? Let me show you something. This data is something that is updated as and when required. So now we have a new client who we have just signed on and he has given us some business in September. Let's add his data in at the last. To do that, since it's a table, let's get to the last column here, G21. And before we press tab, keep your eye on our results of the average and sum formulas with the take function. The moment I press tab to go to the next row in our table, our values in the last 5 rows change. Why? Because since our argument is for the last 5 rows and the moment we create a new row, our formula which was earlier from row 17 to row 21 now shifts to row 18 to row 22. Let's move forward. Write our company name as ABC Constructions and skip all the months but enter some value in the month of September since it's a new client and we have only recently generated any revenue from him. Now look at the functions nested with take. They are all updated but our individual average and sum formulas are stuck with the same old values. Why? Because they have been asked to average and sum certain rows and columns. So that's the biggest advantage with using take in scenarios like these. Let's move to our next example where we are going to build more on this. This time, we have the same data set but with the totals of each client. Now we have to find the top 5 clients who generate the most revenue and bottom 5 in terms of revenue as well. Again, we can use filters to sort this total field here and again, that won't be dynamic. Any new data added to your data set, your filters won't auto-update. But our take function, when written along with SORTBY function, will. Before we begin, Have a look at this sorted list by using the sort option in the filters, with the highest revenue on top and the least at the very bottom. I'll leave it here at the side so we can keep comparing our progress with this. So let's start here. We start by sort by function and select our array as the column with clients' names. And we want them sorted by the total column. Next argument is sort order. But let me show you what happens if we end our formula here. When we press enter, we have our list sorted. But let's see. It has quantum dynamics at the top and then tech next innovation followed by innovate tech solutions. So our list is in ascending order. No problems. Here is where the sort order argument comes into play. So we go to edit our formula by pressing F2, and for sort order, we choose -1 for descending order. Now our list is as it should be, highest revenue on the top. Now let's place this formula in the take function. Our sort by formula will serve as our array, and for rows argument we will choose 5 because we wish to get the top 5 names from this list. Press enter and here we have our top 5 revenue generators. Now to handle the least revenue generators, we can simply copy this formula and change our last argument to -5, and it will pick from the bottom 5. So we simply change the row argument to -5 and here we have our data. This does work, but if you look closely, it gives us Echo Wave Enterprises followed by Aqua Glow, Water Systems, and the list ends with Quantum Dynamics. But Quantum Dynamics is the one with the least revenue. So if you wish to sort it this way, the client with the least revenue should be on the top in this list. If you remember, the sort by function has sorted our list in descending order, which means the lowest revenue is at the bottom. We can change our sort order argument to 1. So our list will be in ascending order and then the lowest revenue will be at the top. Then we can pick top 5 from there. So we simply copy this formula and paste it here and only change the sort order argument of our sort by formula from -1 to 1. Press enter and now we have Quantum Dynamics as the least revenue generator on the top. So it's up to you how you wish to present your data. Again, this whole thing is dynamic, so if we are to enter another row here, ABC constructions, and let's add random values to all the cells this time. Here is our total and you can see how the values here change automatically. Let's move on to our next example. And this time we have the locations added to our data and we need to find the locations which are generating above average total revenue. Let's put our average formula here. Average, and then select the total as the number argument and here we have our average. Now we have to find the top 5 and bottom 5 locations which are higher and lower respectively than average in terms of this number. To do this, we are going to use the filter function along with take. Let's write our filter formula first. Filter, then for array we select a column with country names, then for include argument we are going to select the total column and add greater than or equal to this average value here. Press F4 to make it absolute because we are going to reuse this formula for our bottom 5 task as well. Press enter and here we have the list of all the locations who have equal to or greater than revenue than our average. This is all such locations but we need only top 5 of them. So we add the take function to the mix. And for rows, we mention 5 and press enter. Done. Now copy this formula to here and since we need to find locations which are below average, we will have to change our argument to show less than or equal to our average. So we simply press F2 and go in our formula to change this value to less than or equal to and done. Now we have the names of bottom 5 locations which are generating below average revenue. Now we are at the last example of our video. Using take with VSTACK. It's pretty simple, but it's just like take function, many of you may not be aware of VSTACK function as well. If you don't know about VSTACK, as I said, I have a detailed video about it. You can find the link up top and in the description. In simple words, if you have multiple tables with the same headers, you can get them all in one place with a single VSTACK formula. Check our video if you wish to know more about this useful function. Back to our last example for the day, we have some more companies but in a different table. Let me first show you what VSTACK does and then we will move ahead with using it with take function. If I use the VSTACK formula here, like this, VSTACK, select our first table and then the second one, press enter, it will simply list all the rows and columns of both the tables. And it's totally dynamic too. If we are to add a company at the bottom here, you can see our VSTACK results are updated as well. For this example, we'll keep it simple because our video is already getting quite lengthy. So we will use our simple average formula for all of this array here brought up by VSTACK. You know what? Since we are pressed for time, let's copy this VSTACK formula so we can use this in the array argument in our take function. So we start with our average formula, then take, and for array argument, we paste our copied VSTACK formula. For row argument, let's say we expect more rows to come in, so it's better to skip it. For columns, just as before, we mentioned -6 and done. Here we have the average of both our tables. Let's verify this by selecting from our first table, then press and hold Ctrl while selecting from the second one and we have perfect result. That brings us to the end of this video. Thank you for sticking around and I believe as you become more comfortable with the take function, you can explore advanced usage and some helpful tips. Consider using conditional statements or combining take with other Excel functions to create complex data extraction scenarios. Experiment, practice, and don't hesitate to explore the possibilities. If you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more Excel tips, tricks, and videos. Give us a thumbs up if you're ready to take control of your data. Thank you for joining us today. Keep practicing, keep exploring, and remember, with functions like take, you can extract the data you need with precision. Until next time, happy spreadsheeting.